Hello friends, in previous video we have studied the introduction to the system planning. In this video we are going to study three types of the system planning, that is short term, long term and medium term strategic planning. First of all, let us study the short term strategic planning. Now the short term strategic planning mainly aims at following. First is improving the performance of the existing plant and maximizing its utilization. So whatever generating stations are existing today, it is very important to improve its performance. Also, the proper utilization of the electricity that is generated by the generating station is also important. So the short-term planning consider this. Next is to seek the even power sharing over the circuits of the similar rating. Now whenever there are the circuits that are connected in the similar rating, then the power shared by those circuits should be similar. Next aim is establishing new circuit connections as required, if possible without resource to displacing the lower voltage circuits and highest possible capacity. Next aim is routing new circuits so that they may be readily used for the connection of the future power station or for the supply point to the regional grids. So in case in future there is required for the expansion of the power system, then already the circuit should be routed so that they can be connected whenever required. Next is reduction in the number of levels of the system voltage that is used. Next aim is maintaining the uniformly high but acceptable fault levels. Next, installing capacitors at various voltage levels, that is at the high tension as well as low tension side. Now capacitors are mostly installed for the reactive power compensation. Next, computerizing the work management system so that it is possible to track the recurring problems, then material movement and the maintenance of the history to forecast the maintenance schedule. So all these points are considered for the short-term strategic planning. Next is medium-term strategic planning. Now the broad aims of the medium-term strategic planning are as follows. First is renovation, modernization, upgrading and extension in life of the existing aging power plants. Now the power plants which are installed in the old times, they are now facing the problems of aging. So in case of medium term strategic planning, the main aim is to reconstruct this plant to upgrade them to the latest technology as well as to extend their life. Next aim is the reduction in transmission and distribution losses. Now whenever energy is transmitted and distributed from the generating system to the consumer, it is said that if 1.5 unit is transmitted, then 1 unit is received. So there is always certain losses of the transmission and distribution. So the reduction of these losses is very important. Next aim is construction of shorter gestation plants, that is gas turbine based or combined cycle based or cogeneration schemes, etc. Next aim is energy conservation and load management. Now this is very important. Next aim is adoption of non-conventional energy sources, particularly for rural decentralized energy system. Now we know that there are two sources of energy, conventional sources and non-conventional sources. So non-conventional sources are nothing but the renewable sources of energy. The non-renewable sources which are used extensively for the generation of power system, those sources are on the verge of extinction. So it is necessary to promote the use of renewable or non-conventional sources. Next planning is long-term strategic planning. So some technological, managerial and geopolitical issues require the long-term policy as well as administrative decisions. So this type of decisions come under the long-term planning. So first point is direction for the capacity augmentation to meet the project demand and for accelerating the hydro development. Next is environmental issues in the power development. So there are various environmental issues in the power development. Whenever the energy is developed or energy is created, the pollution also takes place. Also, there is loss of land. So these issues come under the environmental considerations. Next aim is to check the interstate or the regional issues in the water resource development. Now, water resource development basically deals with the rivers. Now, rivers which flow in the two states, there are certain interstate issues. Next is functional and commercial issues in the integrated operations. Then, load and water availability for the thermal power plant development. Next is energy cost and prices, also the resources mobilization. The organizational deficiencies in the power development, that is re-energization of power industry to bring the efficiency in the management process. Next aim is fuel cost, oil cost, quality and transport in the thermal power plant development. Then private participation in the power generation, transmission and distribution. So these are certain aims which come under the short term, medium term and long term planning. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and do subscribe our channel Ekeeda. Thank you.